I want you to imagine a situation like this, where you're setting an event listener after the event has already fired. What happens? Nothing. If this event doesn't fire again, then this event listener never gets called. Now imagine you're using promises and you set an action to occur when a promise resolves here, which is after the promise has already resolved. Guess what? This will execute. Compare this to the event listener example, where the event listener would never get called if it's set after the event already fired. I want to quickly show you some code. This is a promise constructor, and you'll be learning more about this in the next video. This method, resolve, settles the promise. A promise can only settle once. So in this scenario, the second resolve is doing nothing. Nothing's going to happen, it's going to go by unnoticed. Compare this to events. An event can fire many times, but a promise can only settle once. Promises execute in the main thread, which means that they are still potentially blocking. If the work that happens inside the promise takes a long time, there's still a chance it could block the work the browser needs to do to render the page. If so, the frame rate of your app is going to suffer, and you'll probably hear your users complain about jank. Promises are not a pass for safely executing long-running operations. They're simply a technique for deciding what will happen when an asynchronous task settles. Think of them as try-catch wrappers around asynchronous work. Okay, it's time for a quiz.